Blackstone Audiobooks presents
Water Babies by Charles Kingsley. This book bears a dedication to my youngest son, Grenville Arthur, and to all other good little boys. Come read me my riddle, each good little man. If you cannot read it, no grown-up folk can. Chapter 1. Once upon a time, there was a little chimney sweep, and his name was Tom. That is a short name, and you've heard it before, so you will not have much trouble in remembering it. He lived in a great town in the North Country, where there were plenty of chimneys to sweep, and plenty of money for Tom to earn and his master to spend. He could not read nor write, and did not care to do either, and he never washed himself, for there was no water up the court where he lived. He had never been taught to say his prayers. He had never heard of God, or of Christ, except in words which you never have heard, and which it would have been well if he had never heard. He cried half his time, and laughed the other half. He cried when he had to climb the dark flues, rubbing his poor knees and elbows raw, and when the soot got into his eyes, which it did every day in the week, and when his master beat him, which he did every day in the week, and when he had not enough to eat, which happened every day in the week likewise. And he laughed the other half of the day, when he was tossing halfpennies with the other boys, or playing leapfrog over the posts, or bowling stones at the horses' legs as they trotted by, which last was excellent fun, when there was a wall at hand behind which to hide. As for chimney sweeping, and being hungry, and being beaten, he took all that for the way of the world, like the rain and snow and thunder, and stood manfully with his back to it till it was over, as his old donkey did to a hailstorm, and then shook his ears, and was as jolly as ever, and thought of the fine times coming when he would be a man and a master sweep, and sit in the public house with a quart of beer and a long pipe, and play cards for silver money, and wear velveteens and ankle jacks, and keep a white bulldog with one grey ear, and carry her puppies in his pocket, just like a man. And he would have apprentices, 1, 2, 3, if he could. How he would bully them, and knock them about, just as his master did to him, and make them carry home the soot sacks, while he rode before them on his donkey, with a pipe in his mouth, and a flower in his buttonhole, like a king at the head of his army. Yes, there were good times coming. One day, a smart little groom rode into the court where Tom lived. Tom was just hiding behind a wall to heave half a brick at his horse's legs, as is the custom of that country when they welcome strangers. But the groom saw him, and halloed to him to know where Mr. Grimes the chimney sweep lived. Now Mr. Grimes was Tom's own master, and Tom was a good man of business and always civil to customers, so he put the half-brick down quietly behind the wall and proceeded to take orders. Mr. Grimes was to come up next morning to Sir John Hartover's at the place, for his old chimney sweep was gone to prison and the chimneys wanted sweeping. And so he rode away, not giving Tom time to ask what the sweep had gone to prison for, which was a matter of interest to Tom, as he had been in prison once or twice himself. Moreover, the groom looked so very neat and clean, with his drab gaiters, drab breeches, drab jacket, snow-white tie with a smart pin in it, and clean, round, ruddy face, that Tom was offended and disgusted at his appearance, and considered him a stuck-up fellow, who gave himself airs because he wore smart clothes and other people paid for them, and went behind the wall to fetch the half-brick after all, but did not, remembering that he had come in the way of business and was, as it were, under a flag of truce. His master was so delighted at his new customer that he knocked Tom down out of hand and drank more beer that night than he usually did in two, in order to be sure of getting up in time next morning. For the more a man's head aches when he wakes, the more glad he is to turn out and have a breath of fresh air. And when he did get up at 4 the next morning, he knocked Tom down again, in order to teach him, as young gentlemen used to be taught at public schools, that he must be an extra good boy that day, as they were going to a very great house, and might make a very good thing of it, if they could but give satisfaction. And Tom thought so likewise, and indeed would have done and behaved his best, even without being knocked down. For of all places upon earth, Hartover Place, which he had never seen, was the most wonderful. And of all men on earth, Sir John, whom he had seen, having been sent to jail by him twice, was the most awful. Hartover Place was really a grand place, even for the rich North Country, with a park full of deer, which Tom believed to be...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.